Okay, hi Virgo, welcome back to my channel. Guys, if you're new here, welcome. And if you are returning, thank you so much for supporting the channel. So we're going to go ahead and let's look at love, right? Let's see what comes out for my Virgos to do with love. Now, this is a general reading. It will not resonate with everyone. Take the parts that resonate for you and leave the rest. Okay, so what do we have for my Virgos in love, spirit? Give me three cards. Thank you to those who reached out for personal readings. Those who would like a personal reading, my information is always down below, guys. What do we have happening in love for my Virgos? Thank you, spirit. Coming out reversed. Okay. So we have free yourself. Take back. It's time to take back control of your life. But it was in reverse. About love. I don't want to know about finances and career. Thank you. Give me a couple messages from a Virgos in love. Can I get two more cards? Forgiving and learning. All right, give me two cards from a Virgos. What is the energy for the collective? Thank you, spirit. When it comes to love, or I'll take one more. Nothing much happening in love. What's going on? What flew way out there? Getting to know each other. It says, as you reveal your innermost selves to each other, your bond deepens. So some of you met somebody new. But why was the free yourself in reverse, Virgos? Wow, there's someone from the past. What is this getting to know each other? What is the message for love for my Virgos? Why do they keep giving me more than one card? I'm not taking them all. Wedding, flirt, passion. For Virgo, thank you, spirit. Thank you. It came out again anyway. It came out with the free yourself, so you wanted to sit right there. With it being in reverse, this could be your energy, Virgo. This could be somebody else's energy, right? It will be either telling me that somebody hasn't freed themselves from you, or you haven't completely let go of somebody right in front of it, almost as if someone would fall to their knees, right? Forgiving and learning. It says, as you release and heal the past, you experience more love in your present moment. Now, this could be you, Virgos, right? Maybe there is something from the past. We've been getting this energy quite a lot for some of my Virgos. There may be something from the past that didn't work out for you, that didn't go the way you wanted it to, that left you disappointed, right? Almost like the Five of Cups energy. But if you have met somebody new here, Spirit's saying you're going to have to let whatever that is from the past go so that you can move forward. It's almost like I want to say, I don't even want to say that because I almost wanted to say, you're not going to meet the same person twice. Now, you probably won't meet the same person twice. But you might meet certain people that have the same traits as other people, right? Let's see what comes out, Virgo. Two of Cups as I pick up the deck. What is this three yourself? And why was it in reverse? Thank you. Three of Cups. Show me more. Wheel of Fortune. I see the Hermit at the bottom of the deck. And then we have the Nine of Cups. Could this be an energy of, you know what, whoever this is, free yourself from whatever those thoughts were. Free yourselves, right? Now this goat, it kind of looks like a goat. It kind of looks like half a goat, half a unicorn. But whatever it is caged. Now, to me, unicorns are mystical, magical. It would give me the energy of power, unique, different. Free yourself, because the Wheel of Fortune is here. It's time for things to change. It's time for you to celebrate. Nine of Cups, wish fulfillment. It's your turn on the wheel. So why worry about the things from the past? Why worry about the people from the past? Now, with this image here, especially if you guys have met somebody new, right? There could be an element of fear of, I don't know, if somebody in the past put you in a third party. With the Three of Cups here. But again, even if that is the case, I want to leave that in the past. This talks about going forward. This talks about your destiny. This talks about change. This talks about the universe being on your side. And it's really funny. Because with the Nine of Cups and the Three of Cups. Actually, no, it doesn't. I thought it was going to bring me down to the Two of Cups. But it's not. It actually brings me to the Three. It's time to celebrate. It's time to go out there and have fun. It's time for some of you to let your hair down. What is getting to know each other? Give me three cards. Thank you. Queen of Pentacles. Okay. This is your energy. Somebody trying to get to know you, Virgos. Ooh, the Knight of Wands. Okay. Could be dealing with an Aries, Leo, or a Sagittarius. So that Knight of Wands. Wow, there's a lot of cards happening here. Wow, the Four of Wands. What do I feel like somebody wants to come to your home? Maybe, I don't know if somebody wants to speak with you. This Knight of Wands. It could be, like I said, it could be here because maybe you have met somebody new and there's no real commitment here yet, right? Could just be very lighthearted, a little bit flirty. I see the Eight of Cups and the World card, though, wanted to flip over as well. It's giving me this energy, or for some of you, I mean, this could be somebody else, right? Take it out, it resonates. But for some of you, you know, the Eight of Cups is walking away from the Seven of Cups, walking away from illusions, confusion. Some of you, it's even giving me the energy of some of you have options here, Virgo, but you've got your back turned to them. Now, I don't know, maybe some of the options that you have around you ain't viable, right? Why is this Knight of Wands here? Now, for some of you, well, let me see first. Eight of Pentacles, okay, somebody maybe wanting to come in and work on things. This may be somebody at work that may be watching you from a distance. Three of Wands. Show me about this Knight of Wands. Four of Cups. Maybe somebody that you've known already. Again, if this is somebody new and you're kind of pushing, keeping them at a distance. This may be someone here is going to miss an opportunity. This may be someone who doesn't want to miss an opportunity with you. For some of you with the Four of Wands here, this could even be somebody that you are married to, right? That just kept stepping out of the relationship here. Even though you were committed to them, or it could just be represent, maybe you live with them for some of you. But the Knight of Wands, this is someone who is stepping out. This is someone who does what they want, right? This can also be somebody who is a little bit, I want to say immature, but the Knight of Wands. I'm getting easily distracted. I don't know. I'm hearing, I don't know if this is somebody that you already know, guys. This may have been somebody who, how do I say it without triggering somebody? Oh, look, they just said, just tell the truth. It's maybe somebody who would just sleep with anybody who had a heartbeat, right? Not very fussy. Even if that was the case, this person is definitely having some regrets now if this is somebody from your past, right? Four of Cups, missed opportunity. What is the forgiving and learning? Maybe this is why it's out here. The Six of Pentacles. Why is the forgiving and learning out here? King of Swords. Aquarius, Libra, Gemini energy. Show me more. The Eight of Cups wants to come out. And the Empress. What is the Six of Pentacles and the Eight of Cups? Six of Pentacles can sometimes talk about somebody giving to two here. For some of you, there is another energy here. Like I said, an air sign that you may have been dealing with that is kind of feeling stuck with this hanged man. But it's not that just that they're feeling stuck. They're also having some kind of epiphany. Right? The hanged man takes a temporary pause, but he also see something from a different perspective. Some of you may have been dealing with an air sign that is maybe realizing they really didn't give an equal give or take to this situation. So maybe that's why you guys turned your back on this person. But with that mole, it would also tell me here that this person may have been hiding things. Why am I hearing? For some of you that are dealing maybe with an air sign, it doesn't have to be. It could just be somebody who was in that energy where they just thought they were clever about doing something. I'm hearing slippery sucker. So I don't know. What is the hangman? Sun card. Oh, they may be having some kind of epiphany. Well, the sun card talks about illumination as well. So again, there could have been something that came to light about this person. But the Sun card also talks about happiness here, right? And that Eight of Cups is heading towards the Nine of Cups. So what is the King of Swords and the Empress? Is that Chariot? This person may be coming back towards you for some of you. What is a Chariot? Well, the King of Swords and the Empress here. The Four of Swords, forgiving and learning. This is somebody who wants to heal a situation with you. But again, I'm always saying this Four of Swords, right? This person is more concentrating on the damage that was done rather than healing the situation, because the fourth sword he's kind of lying on. So just in thinking mode, not really doing anything there. What is the Chariot and the Four of Swords with this King of Swords and the Empress? Thank you, Spirit. The World card. So they want a new chapter after some kind of an ending. So what is this Knight of Wands? Let's look more into this Knight of Wands. Oh, Three of Swords here. So you know, I don't know if you're dealing with all these people. I don't know if parts of the reading just resonates for you guys, right? Take what resonates. But there's also this Knight of Wands who is also in some kind of heartache, right? With that Three of Swords here. Why is the Three of Swords here for the Knight of Wands? With the Four of Cups. The High Priestess. Okay, because there was also secrets revealed about this person, but the High Priestess could also talk about, hey, you Virgos maybe just have gone very ghost on this person. High Priestess with the Three of Swords. Thank you. The King of Wands. So definitely strong fire here. King of Wands. Now, with that Knight of Wands and the King of Wands, I don't know if this is telling me that there's some maturity here. This person has done some growing. Ooh, the Tower in reverse. This person is going through something major. Tower in reverse. Yep, Ten of Swords, ultimate betrayal. This, I don't know. I feel like either this fire sign put you through something or they're going through something here where it's kind of making them reflect back on you here. The Ten of Cups. Wow, the Ten of Pentacles and the Eight of Swords. And yeah, look at that. I don't know. Look at that. The Seven of Swords with the Ace of Swords is the Eight of Swords again. With the Eight of Swords, this is someone who is very much either in their head here about whatever it is that they did to Virgo, especially if you are being rewarded right now. Ten of Pentacles, Ten of Cups. Or this is somebody who is seeing that they could have had that situation with you here. Seven of Swords, wow, with the Judgment behind it. I don't know if this is someone who is in trouble with the law, that may be facing jail. I don't know. But the Seven of Swords with the Ace of Swords, it looks to me like that's an energy of like getting caught, right? It could just be that they're in a mental prison here. So, wow. Do I even want to get any advice with this? It just kind of looks a bit messy. I think I'll just do the readings day by day and watch how the energy changes. Because like I said, there doesn't seem to be much happening. I can see people wanting to rush in here, wanting to say something, but just in the energy of thinking. So Virgos, that's what I have for you guys today. If this is where we part, Virgos, stay safe, love and light, guys.